It's almost like we can instantaneously speak our troubles away. We can instantaneously talk, and all of a sudden, poof, our lives will ultimately change. When in actuality, my brothers and sisters, it is that every man who is born of a woman is but of a few days, and those days are full of trouble. Sometimes I think it's quite amazing to me how God uses adversity and calamities to make us into the people he's calling for. Any man, woman of God, who is worth their salt, who says to you that they have never been through a storm, is a person who is not positioned for promotion. Because if you are going up in God, you must first go through. Yeah. Isn't it amazing to you how we live in a season to where everybody thinks that they can just speak it and it just automatically happens? But I submit to you tonight that there are some things that you and I must experience before glory comes. Yeah. Some things we've got to go through. There are some things that you cannot pass by. There are some things that you cannot leap over, but you must go through them. Yeah. Adversity and calamities have come to make us stronger. And if you were tonight, would just check yourself, you'd have to wonder tonight, where would you be if it wasn't for your storm? If you check yourselves tonight, you have a greater prayer life, because before God would allow you to arrive, he also ordained your storm. It's amazing tonight that all of us must be nailed to the cross. All of us tonight. If you are ever going anywhere in God, you've got to go through a storm. Got to go through a storm. Jesus is getting ready to be returned to his former glory. But before he is returned to former glory, he must go by Calvary. He cannot be returned to former glory without going to Calvary. Let me tell you tonight, with these few feeble thoughts of mine, that you can never be the person that God has called you to be without going through the nailing of a cross. In other words, my brothers and my sisters, your storm has been ordained by God. You being nailed to the cross, you being crucified, you being talked about, you being lied on, losing houses, losing jobs, losing families, sicknesses and death are all a part of what God has ordained for your storm. It's all a part. And before you get to former glory, before you get to the place that God has called you to, God has to take you by the way of the cross. By the way of the cross. We don't talk about that no more, because everybody really believes that they can just speak it and a house appears. That they can speak it and a car appears. That they've got unexpected money coming in the mail, and that bonuses and raises are just going to happen, and all of a sudden they're finding money and looking for money. But in actuality, my brothers and my sisters, it is the plan of God to take us through a season of humbling. God help me tonight. It is the plan of God. It is the motive of God to take us through a season of adversity to where we only cry and depend upon him. Can you imagine the attitudes that some of us would have if God had not taken us through a storm? I mean, people already can't speak to you. You already think that you're so great and mighty and so wonderful. But can you imagine where we would be if God had not allowed us go the way of the cross. From the sixth to the ninth hour there was darkness. About the ninth hour there was darkness. Let me ask you tonight, have you ever had to find God in the dark? Have you ever had to walk into a room that you were familiar with? Feel the wall for the light switch, flip it, and no light comes on? And all of a sudden, because you think you know the room, you start walking in the dark and trip over something that was left in the floor. Have you ever tried to believe God for what you could not see? To trust him in moving in a maze to where it looked like nothing for you was going to happen. And God says, what I need you to do is to trust me blindly. I'll be through in a minute. I ain't going to keep you. To trust me blindly. What I need you to do is to trust me blindly. So from the sixth to about the ninth hour, there was darkness. Let me submit to you tonight. There's some of you who are listening to me tonight who are in darkness. When this meeting shall have ended this week, you'll go back to darkness. You'll go back to darkness. And isn't it amazing that within that short period of time, from the sixth to the ninth hour, there was darkness? And isn't it amazing that in your darkness, only God has your time schedule? Isn't it amazing that when darkness is upon you, you can want to leave but can't leave? You can want to go but can't go, all because he has assigned you to a period of. Let me hurry. To a period of darkness. And so you find yourself fumbling through the dark. You find yourself trying to move in a maze through the dark, when God says, I'm still here. Even in your darkest hour, I'm still here. There was darkness from the sixth to about the ninth hour, and darkness covered the land. And Jesus cries with a loud voice, Eli, Eli, lema sabachthani, God, God, where are you? Where you at? Where are you? Where are you? I've come tonight to tell you that prior to promotion, you must understand that silence doesn't mean severed. Silence doesn't mean severed. Just because you can't hear from God doesn't mean that God has cut you off. God, let me hurry tonight. Let me hurry. Just because you can't hear him doesn't mean that he has disconnected himself from you. Because Job said, I looked for him. I cried unto him, but I could not hear him. I called him and he would not answer. I looked for him and I could not find him. I could not find him. Even in your darkness, he hasn't cut you off. Just because the church ain't growing don't mean he's cut you off. Just because there always seems to be a fight about ministry, always a fight about control, always a fight about schism that has been created, doesn't mean that God has cut you off. God has an unusual way of bringing us to the point that God would have us to be before promotion comes. Isn't it amazing that whenever God is about to elevate us, he always takes us through a storm. He always takes us through something that will challenge our faith, that will help us to mature into being the people that God has called us to. This is our greatest challenge, is to believe God even when it doesn't make any sense, even when you and I cannot see our way. The greatest responsibility that we have is to trust God even when we can't hear him. Let me hurry. When we can't hear him. Let me ask you a question. Have you ever been there? Have you? I know I have. I've been there to where I couldn't hear him. I couldn't hear him. I was praying, but I couldn't. I could hear the people, but I couldn't hear him. I could hear the claps and the accolades, but I couldn't hear him. I couldn't. And then I began to question my ministry, because I would see other people who were not as talented or as gifted. I know y'all don't think like this, so I'd see other people progressing and I'd see other people growing, but it looked like I had become stagnant because I could not. I could not hear him. So it forced me to put myself in a position to where I had to trust God, even though I did not understand what God was doing. Have you ever been there? Yeah. To where you had to trust God in spite of everything else around you going straight to hell. You had to trust him despite everything around you crumbling. God was forcing you and placing you in a position to where you had to hang on your cross all by yourself, saying, God, where you at? Where you at? Where you at? Where you at, God? Where you at? I'm waiting on. Where are you? My God, why? Why? That's all I want to know. Why you get me out here like this and then I can't hear from you? Why? Why you get me out here like this? Why have you allowed me to become the laughing stock of my community? The embarrassment of my family. The sniggle and griggles of my peers. Why? I know they look at me and be in dismay. They look at me and shake my head. They shake their heads. They smile, but yet there's a conversation about me. So why am I? Why am I here? I'll tell you what he's doing. You see, your silence brings you in alignment with God for your humanistic assignment. So while God is quiet in your life, the challenge that you have is to get closer to him. Because in all reality, you have nobody else to call on. In reality, you have nobody else to lean on. So you find yourself bringing yourself in alignment. Yeah. God says, I need you to get in alignment. It's sort of like going to buy new tires, but if you buy new tires, you need an alignment. You need, because if you buy new tires without getting an alignment, soon the tires will begin to wear. And so what God is saying, you cannot hear from me, but your prayer life has just been increased. You cannot hear from me, but your time with me has just been increased. You cannot hear from me, but your seeking me has just been increased. You cannot hear from me, but you calling on me has just been increased. And all I'm doing, I'm bringing you in alignment. Because this humanistic assignment, your is too great. Whether you've got 20 or 2,000, it's too great. Whether you preached in the convention or preached at the nursing home, it's too great. I wish I had some help up in here tonight. Whether you're a real doctor or an earned doctor or a snowball doctor, it's still too great. Because whatever God has called you to do, he has uniquely called you to do it. I think it's ironic tonight that nobody in this room tonight has your fingerprint but you. Nobody has your fingerprint but you. Nobody has your DNA but you. And I submit to you tonight that that is because God has uniquely made you. Isn't it amazing? Those of us who are preachers, I've been preaching now for about 40 years. Those of us who are preachers spend the first 10 to 15 years trying to find yourself. Always trying to sound like somebody else, not even knowing that God has uniquely made you. And isn't it amazing how when you discover that God has uniquely made you, you start lining up your life with his will. Let me hurry. You start lining up your life with his will. Lining up yourself with him. Why, Keith? Why? Because before declaration, there must be darkness. You can't be declared until darkness comes. Tonight, before declaration, there must be darkness. And in order tonight for you to get to the place that my Lord is calling you, you must go through a period of darkness. Oh, Lord, whatever you want me to do, take me through my moment of darkness. Well, I heard my Lord saying, Lord, tell me, where are you? And why, you know, I've been waiting and calling on you because I really don't know what to do. And so then, Lord, I am moving in a way that will determine what it is that you have called me to do. Did you hear me? And Lord, I know that you have something great for me, but I am waiting on a word from you. Did you hear me? Oh, let me leave here tonight by saying what it is that I really need is just one word from the Lord. Did you hear me? Oh, just one word. It will change my situation. Can I get a word? I heard him say, Lord, tell me, why have you forsaken me? Did you hear me? And you know what my Lord did? He hung his head in the locks of his shoulder. Did you hear me? Gave up the ghost and went on and died. Did you hear me? Sunday morning, and I got to get out of here. Did you hear what I'm saying? Oh, I said early Sunday morning, Jesus, he started moving down in a grave, because darkness, it came before declaration. But Sunday morning was declaration time. That's all I got to tell you. Everybody in this room got a Sunday morning coming. I don't care where you've been. I don't care what you're going through. Sunday morning, I wish I had a windmill. Sunday morning, it's on the way. Touch somebody and tell them your Sunday morning is coming. Did you hear what I'm saying? Whatever it is, Sunday morning is coming. Yeah. Sunday morning is Sunday morning is coming. Oh Lord. Sunday morning is coming. If you hold on, whatever you're going through, he will. Bless you tonight. He will. Do me a favor tonight. Just look at somebody and tell them, be not dismayed. Whatever they tell you.